with the rest of champions. I think Schalke are saying, Gilius, you need to act as the bridge. You need to be that early game playmaker. When you see Illilia on the other side, Lee Sin gonna have a better time finding gank opportunities. But a lot of these lanes for Mad Lions going to be hard to influence. I do feel like a lot of solid laning options here for them.
All right, we're going to talk about your vocabulary and five-head Giga Brain later, but for now, we see the 1v1. Gilius getting caught out here. You do not fight the Lilia at level 1. That is not a winning proposition. They will reset the blue buff, but important to note, Gilius has lost Flash at level 1. For a champion who wants to get something done in the early game, that's going to be a big deal. Meanwhile, on the bottom side of the map, look at the fight coming out here. Dream's just getting run down here. Kaiser lower cooldown on that Q. It means he just keeps running forward, keeps picking fights, and Mad pulling very far.
Waiting to level 2.
Big investment. Kaiser stepped very far forward. Aftershock procced. It will fall away shortly. When it falls away, Kaiser is going to be incredibly squishy. Has a bit more resistance with the W coming in, but Gilius now caught out. He's not going to be able to find anything.
It's all gone wrong.
I mean, 2 summoner spells you pick up, but now Shadow's coming in as well. He can just move into the jungle and take away the Krugs. There's not going to be any response, or he can come down to try to extend the play, but the Ash is just continuing to slow them all down here. Have to be careful coming into this tower, but that's going to be Dream's dead. First blood for Karzy, and an amazing start for the Mad Lions.
Karzy and Kaiser just dunked on Neon and Dreams.
See what Arome wants to do, and if it is the bot lane dives that we talked about in draft.
Yeah, and I wasn't paying super close attention to the top lane early on, but it looks like Arome was the first one to go back to base, and I really like doing
EXP,
this on
which naturally very important for Ashe, means that she can kind of catch you out of guard, get an early level 6, as Odoamne, as soon as they saw a vision of where Karzy was, they immediately ran it back into the bot lane. So it looks like Mad Lions are dictating as Gilius.
Gilius going in, the ultimate immediately to come out. Arome now on the way in. Gilius now being lined up here, but the ulti coming in will only connect on one, and Gilius just on the fast retreat here. A little upset. But now the engage coming out on the bottom side of the map. Karzy just going to kick things off with the arrow. In comes the Lilia. Where's she going to go? Already one dead. They're going to fish for a few more. Kaiser just continuing to run forward. But meanwhile, in the mid lane, the battle between the two mid laners. The slide back. Abadage fishing, but Humanoid's going to be forced to flash out. Abadage holding onto his flash for now. 3 sand soldiers, but no tools left to set them up. Both sides will back away, but flash advantage for Abadage.
Big deal, but the swap's already coming out. He's moving in. When's he going to use the oranges?
Has been knocked up. Is now set up to get knocked down. The move forward. It's a little bit sloppy, but Gilius gets there. The kick flash. That's going to finish the job, and Gilius will grab the kill.
Still really slow setup. I agree with Ender. I think that they were kind of on the wrong page of getting Gilius over the wall, which now means that Mad have had tons of time to set up for this dive.
Oh, knock up, and the ball is going to hit, and that's going to be one sleepy Forge God. Unstoppable now, but certainly not unkillable. Near flawless dive from the side of Mad Lions.
Really nice control there. Now, Humanoid, Gilius is rushing towards him. This
Abadage
is a 2v1.
Scoop back, that's going to be one tower shot. Now the pullback in exchange, though. Gilius running in, looking for something. That's 2 low health members. Gilius, no kick available, though. Does not want to pull the trigger. But Mad Lions, once again, in a game situation where they are pulling ahead, 3k in their favor, fishing for engages. They're going to miss the ball. They're going to miss the arrow. Abadage going to get pulled back, though. Humanoid manages to find his, and that's going to be a clean combo. Schalke baited into a false sense of security here, and Shadow going to grab the double on the back end of that one.
That was a
2. This is what I was talking about. When Lilia starts rolling, she does not stop. Let's check it out one more time here, because it is the arrow that goes wide at the start, but then it's this ultimate into the Leona ultimate. That is complete devastation. Schalke got destroyed.
Absolutely obliterated in that exchange. And if I were Schalke, I would have felt good too. I think if Schalke are going to win out, it's going to be a lot on his
Check
shoes.
This out.
Now Arome going to get kicked back. Going to move through. Sand Soldier's already set up though. Abadage is really out of cooldowns here. He does not have the looking at it 22 minutes into the game.
Uh-oh.
40 to 35. If they find a few picks here, they are going to be pretty comfortable to start the Baron, but Abadage will not go quietly. Not going to set up the tower yet, but the pushback onto Humanoid. Humanoid just walking around him, but now Shadow on the backside. This will be big. Humanoid, though, taken down right in time. Abadage has to run for the hills. He's going to be sleeping. Gilius trying to body block.
Get Odo!
Denying the follow-up, buying time for the mid lane. In the meantime, the rest of the team falling apart. The GP in the midst of everyone. Neon trying to get something done. The heals are coming through right on time. Schalke managed to find it. Mad Lions overforced, and Abadage finds his moment to bring the game back around.
Oh!
He's trying to do it, but no! Shadow on a killing spree will deny him. Neon now on the chase, so this is massive for Schalke. They need to keep the fight going. Neon chasing down Arome slowly but surely. Shadow now running. The movement speed is there. The sidesteps are there. The chilling smite is coming through, but it's too little. It's too late. Shadow will drop. Schalke doesn't look like they have the members for the Baron, but they'll take a massive fight in their favor.
Making sure that Mad Lions cannot collapse with enough time, and another engage by Dreams.
Hook, Neon throwing a Q across 3. That's going to be big healing. Now Kaiser split from the rest of the team. Arome has to run for the hill. He's been locked up. Where's the follow-up? Where's the follow-up?
Oh,
he will manage to make it out. now Neon out as well. Dream's gonna go move forward. Avandagi in the midst of everyone, but he has been locked up, but he's gonna get taken down. Karzi showing up right when it matters most. The Ashe throwing down so much damage as the Orianna and the Leona will grab the kills. And here comes Shadow. That's gonna be one sleepy Nautilus. That's gonna be one easy Baron. And just like that, the ball.
Shu is now on the other foot though. Mad Lions completely shake off the overforce of the top lane. They turn towards the Baron. They pick up the team.
They don't care about getting the Cloud Soul right now. They are in the lead, but Shock want to punish Humanoid.
It's gonna be big. Shockwave comes out. Ulti will not connect. Rome now running down.
Here comes Kaiser.
Arrow will connect onto Dream.
Look
not
at Kaiser.
Priority target, but he's so squishy. He has to proc Aftershock, and the Gargoyle Stoneplate comes out too little too late. Kaiser now running in. He's going to lock up Gilius. The ball will connect. Neon's going to be sleepy. That's going to be massive. Karzi now running forward. He sees his prey. He sees his target, but they turn it just like that because Avandage shows up just in time. He steps back, though. He can't afford. The Shurima Shuffle will not come out. He's just trying to retreat for now. They're holding on. Mad Lions continuing to push forward.
Team fight for that last world spot.
It's crucial to give them some confidence because for the second half of the split, it was a bit of a downward spiral, but this is them punishing Schalke after they miss. Check it out. The arrow comes through. It's Katniss Everdeen right there, landing that one onto Dreams. And then the GP ult to slow down as Kaiser comes swinging in from behind. It is just a thing of beauty watching Mad Lions collapse and punish a Schalke that were four members in the bottom lane with Abadage stranded up topside.
This is dangerously close to just being game over. Now, the good news is Karzi overstays his welcome just a bit, as does Shadow, which means it delays the play a bit. Avandage is able to hold on, able to stop them from pushing in for too much more. But
15,
at the end of the day,
but Mad's ability to just make instantaneous picks is pretty high.
Here we go.
Potentially caught out. Eyes on the Orame. That's going to be four members.
Gilius!
Massive! The shutdown as Gilius finally finds his angle on the backside. He's going to leap back into the rest of the team, but Karzi remains untouched, now stepping forward, flashing over the wall, trying to get something done. Goes golden just in time, but that's just going to do it. There's no room for this Ashe to maneuver. Shadow trying to turn this one back. He will take down Neon, but no. Schalke just moving through. The tanky member's the last one standing, but all eyes on Shadow. He does so much damage, and now it's the battle.
He's just running in circles right. Odwanda, you gotta go, but there's nothing you can really do. Shadow, wait for it to tip.
The knockup. Just moving.
Yeah.
Might not have a dash, but he's
the brittle's
so fast.
Gone. It's all over. Run him down, Shadow.
It's the mental game.
Quick. The swirl sweep, though, not coming through. Shadow. See how fast Shadow's going. He's stacking up all this for now. Scryer's coming out. Shadow incredibly low.
That's a counter TP behind. That's Humanoid, who has ultimate.
Let's go. Round two. Ring the bell, Humanoid.
Avandage is going to teleport in too. Everyone's joining the fight.
But Odawame in the midst of everyone. He will not find a knockup. He's now trying to retreat. Unstoppable use. Kaiser coming in, but Avandage is going to be careful. The perfect CC here, and Avandage going to get shut down. No, he pushes
Gilius
him back.
Has fight.
He's
Gilius
holding on
fight.
For now. He wants to finish off Shadow, but he can't do it. Gilius now moving in. He's kept the dream alive. The rest of the team now needs to back off, though, because it's Orome on the backside. Shalgard is going to get picked to pieces. In comes the Ashe. Gilius trying to finish the kill desperately, but Shadow, he's just prancing around.
Oh.
He can't be stopped. The double kill coming through.
This
make
is it.
A
it's
triple
over.
Kill. Mad Lions will bring us to match point in a bloody brawl around the Cloud Soul.
The base is open. Neon doing his best to try and hold on, but the super minions are there. Mad Lions are four members strong inside of the base. It was a chaotic 60 seconds, but Mad Lions continue to come on top and are going to bring themselves to match point.
Finally fighting on their terms, on their footing, with their comfort picks. This is the Mad Lions that people have wanted to see for the entire back half of the split, and they are now looking at match point.
Mad Lions will not fall to the miracle run. They will keep their hopes and dreams for worlds alive as they move up to match point versus Schalke, no fear.